In 2019, YouTuber Jimmy Donaldson, aka MrBeast, and Mark Rober, and another creator who's also a former NASA engineer, decided to do something about the deforestation crisis. They launched a campaign called Teamtrees with the goal of planting 20 million trees.
Today, we will be planting 20 million trees. Yeah!
The response to the campaign was overwhelming. Within days, thousands of people had donated, and the word began to spread on social media. People from all over the world were inspired to take action, and soon the campaign had raised enough money to plant millions of trees. And on October 2022, they announced that their Teamtrees charity campaign has successfully planted more than 20 million trees around the world. One tree planted for every dollar donated by supporters. The campaign planted the trees in 30 countries and 11 U.S. states with its planting partner, the Arbor Day Foundation. So, how did they manage to plant this much of trees with limited time and with limited manpower? One of the methods they used was drone planters. Mark Rober posted a video on his channel titled, "Using Drones to Plant 20 Million Trees." In his video, Mark Rober meets with a company called Mast Reforestation, formerly known as Droneseed, to discuss and demonstrate their drones. Instead of sending out manual work crews armed with shovels, Droneseed reforests using heavy lift drone swarms. They do this in two steps. First, they send out a smaller recon drone that uses lasers to create a 3D map of the terrain. And then from that, they use software to find all the best spots to drop the seeds to maximize their survivability. And then they create a flight path for each of the drones to fly autonomously. Then they load up the drone with a bunch of seed pods that will drop from the sky. The heavy lift drones are outfitted with a pneumatic firing system, which allows them to place the planting pods at the optimal depth into the soil. This allows the team to get into trickier areas where human planters wouldn't be able to enter. Pre-treated seeds have to be encapsulated in a protective shell so that they can survive being fired pneumatically into the ground from a height by a drone. Clay pellets or gel packets are often used to surround the seed. Some companies add chili to the capsule to make it distasteful to clever foragers, like squirrels, or passing birds who might swiftly end the seed's chance of ever growing up. These drones can operate in swarms to deliver pucks of seed to the planting site under the supervision of a couple of skilled operators. Aftercare can involve drones equipped with tanks of herbicides to kill competing weeds and grasses that might overgrow the developing tree seedling, or deliver liquid fertilizer to boost the young tree's growth and establishment. The subsequent germination success and survival rates must be measured by camera-equipped drones in the months and years after the initial planting. Drone seeding is 6 times faster than a human tree planter and can propagate 40 acres in a single day. Moreover, drones can be airborne over post-wildfire sites within 30 days. Speeding up the process of reforestation is important. Because of the compounding crises of climate change, wildfires, and forest loss, accelerating the pace and scale of reforestation is essential by whatever means. According to the IPCC report in 2018, limiting global warming will need 1 billion hectares of new forested area, about the area of the US. Amazingly, our planet has space for it.